This is our topic of a consideration today. Again, the topic has been started yesterday's class. Some basic definition and basic results have been proved. Now, let us move further. Today, we are to discuss unique features of Boolean algebra. And the first unique feature is the Boolean algebra has only a finite set of elements. In Boolean algebra, we have only two elements. The element is 0 and 1, and which are usually called false or true. So this is a finite set of elements which we use in a Boolean algebra. But whereas in ordinary algebra, we deals with infinite number of elements. Now, the infinite number of elements can be the set of integers, can be the set of real numbers, can be the set of a complex number. So this is the first feature in Boolean algebra. The second is, one more thing is, all the variables and constants in Boolean algebra have only two possible values. The first is 0 and the second is 1. Hence, it provides the operation and rules for the working with the set of 0 and 1. So, it provides the operations and works within this set, 0 and 1. Boolean algebra does not have operations equivalent to subtraction and division. So, it does not have operations equivalent to subtraction and division. This is the second unique feature. The third one is in ordinary algebra, there is no equivalent set of unary operation in ordinary algebra. But here in this Boolean algebra, we have a unary operation. The unary operation is generally written as a dash or as a bar. So there are two ways to write down the operation, either by a dash or by a bar. So the next unique feature, is that in Boolean algebra, cancellation law does not hold. That is, A plus B is equal to A plus C does not imply B is equal to C. This is very important. But in a discrete algebra, it holds. Ordinary algebra. In ordinary algebra, it holds. The same thing is for multiplication law. So A dot B is equal to A dot C does not imply B is equal to C. So this is the other unique feature of a Boolean algebra. Now let us move further and discuss some basic operations. We will overview these basic operations. The basic operations for 0 and 1, the logic 0 is there and logic 1 is there. 0 is used for false, 1 is used for true. 0 is used for off, 1 is used for on, 0 is used for low, 1 is used for high. This is some of the basic common ones or common logic operations. Open, 0 is used for open, 1 is used for closed, and 0 is used for no. 1 is used for yes. So now we have the first basic operation which we are going to define, that is OR operation. Each variable in Boolean algebra has either true values, that is 0 or 1. 0 is for false, 1 is for true. The operations can be written like this. 0 plus 0 is give 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and the last one is 1 plus 1 is 1. So these are the four basic operation used for OR. Now, it means if the input values are, input is 0, here is 0, this is 1, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 1, then we can find out the OR operation A plus B, and A plus B will be 0, 1, 1, 1. And similarly, we have the second basic operation, that is AND operation. AND operation means it is used for multiplication, as OR operation is used for addition. Addition symbol has been used there. So AND is for multiplication. And we can write on the multiplication, that is 0 into 0 gives 0. 0 into 1 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. And the last one is 1 into 1 is 1. So we can easily show the input and output again. These are the input values, and this is the output value. And you can write down the column for A into B also, that is 0, 0, 0, and 1. And your output can be denoted as C. So C is the output. It is for OR operation or AND operation. In the similar way, we have the complement operation. The complement, as we know, that 0 complement is 1 and 1 complement is 0. So if we have input column A, then we can find out the output column A dash. So if input is 0, then the complement will be 1, and 1, the complement will be 0. So this is the input and this is the output. So these are the three basic operations. Now there are switching circuits. In the switching circuit we have this, then it means the switch is open. This symbol is used for open, and this symbol is used for closed. This is in a switching circuit. Now let us move to the basic. With the help of 0-1 input, we can also verify De Morgan's law. You can easily verify De Morgan's law. Now, we have logic gates. The first logic gate is OR gate. This is your first logic gate, and OR gate symbol is like this. This is the symbol for OR gate. And if A is the input, B is the input, then your output C can be written as A plus B. Second one is for AND gate, and your AND gate symbol is, if A is the input, B is the input, then your AND gate is like this. This is your output, C is equal to A into B. And the third gate is NOT gate. The NOT gate can be having a symbol. This is the symbol for NOT gate. And NOT is used for complement. Right on here. This gate is also used for complement. So if A is the input, then output is A complement. So C is A complement. You can easily verify these with the help of a table. So you can give the input and output. The table values will be like this. This is the output, input and output for NOT gate. And this is the input and output for OR gate, and this is for AND gate. So you can also take three values of input, A, B, C. So if we are taking three inputs, so you can also verify the OR gate with the help of a table. So in that case, if C has been used here, so you can name it as F. This is a new function, new Boolean function. So we have a three gate, OR and NOT. The next one is NOR gate. NOR mean not OR gate. So if we have a not OR gate, it mean in front of AB, this is the input is AB. So this gate is for OR, and in front of OR, this is the output A plus B. We can place NOT gate. So this is the switching diagram, and your NOT mean A plus B complement. So complement can be written either by a dash or by bar. The same meaning is there. So you can write in either of the ways, and your output gate will be the resultant gate will have a diagram. Input is A, output is B. So you will have the diagram like this. So there you will place a NOT symbol. This small circle is used for NOT. So it can be written as A plus B bar. So F is the output. This is for A plus B bar. So you can show this with the help of table also. So you can find out the output. Input are 1100, and this is 1010. So you will have 1 plus 1, that is 1, and its complement will be 0 0 0 and 1. So this is the truth table. This is the truth table for NOR gate, NOR gate. So in the same manner, we can find out the next gate, which is a NOT AND gate. So the fifth one is NOT AND gate, and in that case, we have to use AND gate here. Input values are A, B. So this is the symbol for AND, and in front of that AND output will be A into B, and your NOT gate will be like this. So this is your NOT AND gate, and output come out to be A into B complement. It can be written by F. So a NOT gate series with an AND. So the gates are in series. This is a NOT gate, you can write down here, and this is AND gate. So both the gates are in series. So symbol for NOT AND will come out to be AB is the input values. So AB are input. So this is used for NOT. So NOT AND gate symbol is this, and the output will be A into B complement. And you can also find out A into B complement here. You will have the value, and the values come out to be 0, 1, 1, 1. You can check it. So this is for NOT AND gate. Now, next we have exclusive OR gate. So for exclusive OR gate, the full form of OR gate is, OR gate full form is inclusive OR gate, and the exclusive OR gate is different. It gives an output of 1 when either but not both inputs are 1. just see exclusive OR gate. It can be simply written as XOR gate. So it gives output 1 when either but not both inputs are 1. Remember, so we can find out the symbol for that or the symbol for XOR gate, and you can also plot the truth table for the input values AB, and your F is exclusive. A is exclusive OR gate with B, and it is written like this. That is A complement B plus AB complement. So simply I say that this symbol is used for XOR gate. Is 0110. You can check it. Let us check for first. So 0XOR0. So 0 complement come out to be 0 complement 0 plus 0 complement. So it come out 0 complement is 10 plus 01. So you can see that the output come out to be 0. So we can easily write on the just see. You can use just see 0 into 1 is 0. Remember, this is 0 into 1 is 0 in AND gate. We have 0 into 1 is 0 and 1 into 0 is also 0. Remember, so what does it mean? We have to write on that is 0 into 1 or 1 into 0 is 0, and this is also 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. This is the identity law of Boolean algebra, and we can write down that expression. Now let us see the symbol for XOR gate. So the input are AB, and your symbol for OR gate is this. So this is the symbol for OR gate, and here you will draw this line. This is the symbol for is A XOR B. Now next we have XOR mean exclusive OR gate, and next we have X exclusive NOR, or it can be written as X NOR. This is the gate exclusive NOR gate. So exclusive NOR gate is equivalent to an exclusive OR gate. So XNOR gate is equivalent to exclusive OR gate followed by an inverter. The output is 1. Output is 1 only when both inputs are either 0 or 1. And this is very easy to do now. And the XNOR output, first of all, write on the truth table. AB inputs are there, and your output function will be the XNOR operation can be written. Operation can be written like this. F is equal to AB plus A complement B complement, and this is for A एक्स एन ओ आर विद बी एंड इट कैन बी रिटन एक्सक्लूसिव नॉर गेट और एक्सक्लूसिव और गेट का नेगेटिव द नेगेटिव ऑफ एक्सक्लूसिव और गेट सो दिस इज एक्स ओ आर गेट सिंबल ए एक्सक्लूसिव और गेट विद बी एंड इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट और नॉट सो दिस इज द ऑपरेशन फॉर एक्स एन ओ आर एंड नाउ वी कैन प्लॉट द इनपुट फाइंड आउट द इनपुट इन द ट्रुथ टेबल सो एफ इज ए बी प्लस ए बार बी बार सो यू कैन राइट डाउन द टेबल हेयर दिस इज जीरो 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 वन एंड वन जीरो एंड वन वन एंड द आउटपुट कम आउट बी वन जीरो जीरो वन एज वी हैव रिटन आउटपुट इज वन वेन बोथ इनपुट्स आर इधर जीरो जस्ट सी इन द फर्स्ट लाइन बोथ इनपुट्स आर जीरो सो द आउटपुट इज वन एंड इन द लास्ट लाइन बोथ इनपुट्स आर वन सो द आउटपुट इज वन सो दिस इज द वे फॉर फाइंडिंग आउट द इनपुट एंड आउटपुट्स नाउ लेट अस चेक दिस suppose we have a is 1 and b is 0 then you can find out the output f is ab plus a complement b complement so this is ab 1 0 plus b is 1 so it come out to be 1 into 0 this is AND operation So this is 0 and this is also 0. So 0 plus 0 by identity property, we should have 0 plus 0 is always 0. So this is the idempotent law, sorry. This is the idempotent law of Boolean. So 0 plus 0 is always 0. So this is the output we have written over here. Similarly, we can check all the cases, case number 1, case number 2, and case number 4 also. This is the case number 3 we have been verifying. Now let us discuss the symbol for XMOR gate. Sorry. So first of all, we need to plot this operation, this is for XOR, this is AB, and your XOR will be, this is the symbol for XOR operation, and in front of this, we should have a NOT gate. So this is the symbol for NOT gate, and your output come out to be A, XOR B, and its complement. So this is the symbol or the logic diagram for XMOR gate. And this is the NOT gate. This B. Input values are AB. So we have the symbol. This is the symbol for XOR and NOT. So this is the output for XMOR gate. So this is very important and its output should come out to be AB plus A bar B bar. So these are some important gates which are important to use in Boolean algebra. Next, we have a very interesting term that is the sum of products. This is used as SOP and product of sum. Product of sum is POS form. So we have these two forms. A Boolean expression simply written as E is said to be a sum of product forms if E is a sum of two or more products of variables. Variables can be in complemented form or in uncomplemented form. So just like this, E can be written as X, Z complement plus एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस एक्स वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट जेड. सो दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल फॉर एस ओ पी. इन द सिमिलर मैनर सॉरी वी कैन डिफाइन पी ओ एस. सो ए बूलियन एक्सप्रेशन ई इज सेट टू बी इन ए प्रोडक्ट ऑफ सम्स इफ इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेवरल सम टर्म्स लॉजिकली मल्टीप्लाइड. Just like this is a sum term, it is multiplied with this sum term. So this is a product of sum form POS. We can take one more example of this. This is x plus y complement plus z into x plus z. This is also an example of a product of sums, and these terms. In sum of products in SOP, these simple terms are known as min terms. So this is another definition, and in POS form, these sum terms are known as max terms. So this is the definition of min term and max term. So a min term of n variable. Is a product of n literals in which each variable appears exactly once in either true or in complemented form, but not both. So this is the meaning of a min term. For example, we have the min term x y, we have the min term x complement y. X y complement x complement y complement. लेकिन same variable cannot be written twice. Just like I am giving the example. Suppose I have x bar y, but if I write x bar again, so this is wrong because the same variable cannot be written here. This is the same variable x bar x bar. X bar is in complemented form, y is in uncomplemented form. So this is not possible in case of min terms. Similarly, in case of max term, no variable in a repetition form. So if n variables are forming max terms, if n variables are forming min terms or max terms, then we should have 2 raised to power n min terms and 2 raised to power n max term. So n variables can be combined to form 2 raised to power n min terms or 2 raised to power n max terms. 2 raised to power n, the maximum possible combinations. This is the meaning I am saying. So suppose I have n is equal to 2. It means we have two variables, either a or b. So the maximal possible combinations will be 2 raised to power 2, that is 4. Like this, we will have combination a, b, a bar, b, a, b bar, or a bar, b bar. Either you use bar or use dash. Bar or dash is used for a complement. So we have an important note here. The important note is that any single min term will be zero except for a single combination of the values of the literals, while any single max term will be one except for a particular combination of the values of literals. For example, the example is, suppose we have x, y complement z, it will be zero, for any combination of x, y, and z, except x is zero, y is x is 1, y is 0, and z is 1. This is the meaning. I am repeating again. any single minterm will be zero except for a single combination of the values of literal, while any single maxterm will be one. The single maxterm will be one. The maxterm I am taking x y complement plus z complement, it will be one for any combination of x y z. X is zero, y is one, and z is zero. This is I am saying. And further, we shall have a Boolean function. A Boolean function. Boolean function is a combination of the variables, and a Boolean function written by f is written as a sum of minterms. If it is a sum of minterms, suppose this is x y complement z plus x y z complement plus x y complement z complement. So this is a sum of minterms. It is known as minterms expansion or DNF, and DNF is known as disjunctive normal form. This is a disjunctive normal form. Similarly, we will have another Boolean function f, and if it is like this, that we have two variables x and y. This is x plus y into x complement plus y. So this is a product of sums form, and this is the complete product of sums form, or this is known as maxterms, or it can be said as a CNF form. CNF form is a conjunctive normal form. So remember, TOS is also said to be CNF, and SOP is said to be DNF. And both the forms are known as canonical forms. Either it is a CNF form or it is a DNF form. So now we have a question. The question is, you just need to express the Boolean function. The Boolean function is of three variables, x, y, z. This is just like x plus y complement z. You have to express this in SOP form. SOP means in a sum of minterms. So it has three variables, and the first term is x. It is missing in two variables. So therefore, we can apply this rule. This is the complement rule we have. A plus E complement is 1. So this first term, x, can be written like this. Y plus y complement. And this is xy plus xy complement. So now in the next, in this also, in this, earlier y was missing in the term x. Now in this term, the z variable is still missing. So this x is equal to xy plus xy complement can be written as xy z plus z complement, and xy complement z plus z complement. So this is the procedure for writing down the given Boolean function in SOP form. So you can have xyz plus xyz complement plus xy complement z and plus xy complement z complement. Now this is the expression written for x, and this is an expression involving all the three variables x, y, z. Now let us talk about the second term, y complement z. Now in the second term, y complement z, the variable x is missing. So It means we can use the complement property again. This is the complement property. So x plus x complement into y complement z can be written. So x y complement z plus x complement y complement z. Hence, the given Boolean function of three variables x, y, z. This is the function, original function, x plus y complement z can be written as, write down, name it as 1 and name it as 2. So write down the value from 1 and 2 equations. So x, y, z complement, x, y complement z plus x, y complement z complement. Plus from second, we shall have x, y complement z plus x complement, y complement z. Now we have written the expressions. Now you can use the theorem. The theorem is a plus a is a. And your name of this theorem, write down very neatly. A plus a is equal to a. This is the property actually, and this property is idempotent property or idempotent law. So we can use this law here. So just see the same expression. This is and this expression, both expressions are same. So it can be written one time only by using this idempotent law. So x, y complement z plus x, y complement, z complement, plus x complement, y complement, z. Now this is the resultant form of SOP. That is a sum of terms or min terms. In the similar manner, we can also find out the terms as a product of max terms. So we can have a question like this. The question is, express the Boolean function. The Boolean function is f x y z again. The expression is x y plus x complement z as a product of max terms. Okay. In place of variable x y z, we can also have different variables. Remember, these variables can be in any form. Suppose I take this question in ABC variable form. So this is AB plus A dash E. And you have to express this as a product of some form or a product of max terms. So now we have the expression by a distributive property. You know that A plus B into C can be written as A plus B into A plus C. This is the distributive property. Now, this property can be used here to find out POS form. So, this can be written, and this is AB plus A dash C. So AB can be written as AB plus A complement and into AB plus C C. This is by distributive property. Further, by distributive law, again, A plus A complement into B plus A complement can be written. And here, we shall have A plus C into B plus C. This is again by distributive law. Now we can use the complement property. By complement, this is equal to 1. So the remaining result is B plus A complement, A plus C, and then we have B plus C. Now we have three terms left. And this is first, and this is second, and this is third. In the first term, it can be written by commutative law, A dash plus B. In the first term, C, the third variable C is missing. So we can use this property here, that is a complement is equal to zero. Now a complement is equal to zero is the complement law. So the complement law of Boolean algebra can be used here. So a complement plus b can be written as a complement plus b plus a cc complement, just to add the third variable. Now in the second term we have a plus c. This is the second term. Here the third variable b is missing, so we can add b complement. In the last term we have a variable missing, so it can be written as a complement. Now we can simplify by the help of distributive. So this is by the help of a distributive. It can be written as a complement plus b. This can be written as b plus c into b plus c complement. This is by this distributive property. And furthermore, it can be written as a complement plus b plus c, and a complement plus b plus c complement. And the next term can also be written in the similar manner, c plus d and c plus b complement. Again, by distributing property, we shall have a plus c plus b into a plus c plus b complement. In the similar manner, we can write down for third term also. First of all, use distributive here. C plus a complement, and further distributive can be used. B plus c plus a complement. Now you can write the terms in a systematic manner, in the sequence order. So this term can be written as a plus b plus c by using commutative property, and by using commutative property here also. Similarly, this is a plus b plus c by commutative property. This is a complement plus b plus c. Now we have the resultant expression. So the Boolean expression in the form of POS can be written as a plus b plus c into a plus b complement plus c into a plus b plus c. This is for a plus c, b plus c. And this is for a complement plus b. Now this is our a complement plus bc. A plus b plus c is there. Okay. This is a plus b plus c and into a complement plus b plus c. Now you just see, we can use the idempotent law here. So a into a is a. This is by idempotent law, and idempotent law can be used here. A plus b plus c, a plus b plus c. So a plus b plus c into a plus b complement plus c, a complement plus b plus c. So this is the result we have. By this result, we have been able to write down the required POS form as a product of sum form, or in the form of product of max terms. So this is a very good way to write down. Now you can simplify the questions suppose I have a question. The question is like this. You just need to simplify the expression. The expression is xy plus x complement z plus y into z. And you need to use a simplification procedure. By simplification, you can have x complement z plus here. You can use the complement property x plus x complement is 1. So you can use here, that is x plus x complement. And further, it can be written here, that is xy plus x complement z plus this is yz x, but a commutative law can be used. So xyz can be written. Similarly, by a commutative law, x dash yz can be written. Now the variable z is missing here. You can use this property, and that is 1 plus z is equal to 1. And you know that 1 plus z is equal to 1 is boundedness law. So by boundedness law, we can write down xy into 1 plus z plus here. Actually, here we are taking xy common. Xy from this and this term is taken common. Similarly, x dash z is common from this term and this term. So you will have 1 plus y. And now you can use the boundedness law for simplification. So xy plus x dash z. This is the required simplified form of the given Boolean expression. Now we have another question. The question is, simplify the expression a plus b into a plus b plus a into a complement plus b. And it can be written a plus b a plus bb plus a complement plus ab. Now we know that a complement is 0. So a complement is 0, and this is by complement property. And further, it can be written a plus ba. Here b into b is b. This is by idempotent property. So b can be written, and you can write on the last term, that is ab. Now a plus b can be taken common. So that is a plus 1 plus ab. Now by boundedness property, a plus 1 should be 1. And it can be written a plus b plus ab. Now b can be taken common, so we shall have 1 plus b. Again by boundedness property, this is 1. So this should be a, not b here. This should be a. So this is 1 plus a. So a plus b. And this is by boundedness property, that is equal to 1. So the resultant simplified form is a plus b. Now this form can be, this is the required form. The same questions, both this one and the previous one, can also be verified with the help of truth table. So you can take the input values in the form of 0 and 1 and find out the resultant output. You should verify this also with the help of truth table. Now in the next part, or in the next lecture, we shall move further with the explanation of K-map. So we shall continue in the next class. and discuss the key maps. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.